We have appointed women to our superior courts, and we have continued the process begun by Prime Minister Zulfikar Ali Bhutto, who had opened the doors of the subordinate judiciary to women. When Prime Minister Zulfikar Ali Bhutto first recruited women in Pakistan's police forces, while he recruited women in Pakistan's police forces, we have consolidated this process by opening women's police stations where women can feel more comfortable in reporting crimes against them. Believing that economic independence is the key to free choice and to freedom and dignity, we have opened a women's development bank. The women's development bank employs only women and gives loans only to women. Through credit given by this bank, a number of businesses by women have sprung up in Pakistan, and we hope to see business by women grow. 40 women computer centers are being opened all across the country to give computer skills to women. 100,000 women are to be recruited in Pakistan's war against population growth and infant mortality. By the end of this year, 35,000 women workers will be in place, saving the lives of our children and saving the strength of the mother and enabling the mother to make choices for herself. Legal aid centers, women's hospitals, women's jobs are all part and parcel of our endeavors to give women what the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, promised over 1,400 years ago, dignity, equality, and respect. In Pakistan, we have taken the battle for the struggle for the rights of women to every province, to our villages, to the floor of our national and provincial assemblies. Our electronic media has run ads educating women that domestic violence is a crime which they can report. We have repeatedly sought to provide role models to the girls and young women of our nation. This is not to say that men, some of whom are present here today, have no role in emancipating women. Men can suppress and men can help emancipate. While I, as many of you, have faced male prejudice in many forms, I succeeded because my own father lived up to the Islamic tenets and made no discrimination between his sons and daughters. At the tender age of 16, he sent me to the best universities of the world, believing that in Islam, knowledge is important and his daughter must not be denied this Islamic right to knowledge. He left me with independent economic means without which I would not have been able to sustain myself or to devote myself to my people, to my country. It was my father who inspired me and encouraged me and gave me the strength and confidence to express my views. More than anything else, he always believed his daughter would be prime minister when such a thing was unheard of in the Muslim world. And I'm grateful to the people of Pakistan and to the workers of the Pakistan People's Party who accepted me not only as their leader, but as their sister, who gave their lives and their liberties and their youth to support our movement for a Muslim social democratic order. As I speak before you today, many of our martyrs come to mind and their families, their womenfolk, whom I consoled, their courage and dignity in the face of tragedy was remarkable. It is the irony of life that while there are men who suppress and men who emancipate, so there are women who suppress and women who emancipate. And this is a phenomenon which we would like to share with you. In Pakistani society, we often hear of mother-in-laws suppressing their daughters-in-law, and then the daughters-in-law grow up and do exactly what the mother-in-law did. Why? I do not have the answers, These answers and their solutions can only come through a debate and discussion by Muslim women. And I feel proud that we are beginning that discussion collectively today. Of course, it is not easy being a Muslim woman. We Muslim women recognize that. The obstacles are greater. The demands are greater. The barriers are greater. The double standards are greater. And the expectation of all those who look to us as role models are greater. Those of us who have chosen to work have broken new ground. We have broken stereotypes. Without bitterness, we who have gone that extra mile are judged by higher standards, held more accountable. In other words, we have had to outperform, outdistance, outmanage men at every level. But we should not shrink from that responsibility. We should welcome it. Welcome it on behalf of women all over the world, in cities and in rural villages, in the great universities. For all who suffered before and for all who come after us, we are privileged to be in this special position, in this special time, with this extraordinary opportunity to change the future. Distinguished ladies, I thank you for coming to Pakistan. I thank you for coming to Islamabad. And I thank you for attending the first Muslim Women's Conference. I would like to leave you with two parting words. First, from the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, who believed that the best veil is the veil in the eyes. And finally, to say that the moment has come in history for us to write her story. Thank you very much.
سامعین محترم، اب افتتاحی خطاب کے بعد کانفرنس کا ورکنگ سیشن ہوگا، جس میں کانفرنس کی چیئر پرسن اور تین وائس چیئر پرسن اور رپورٹیئر کا انتخاب ہوگا. محترم سامعین، اس انتخاب کے بعد سہ روزہ کانفرنس میں بحث کے لیے چار موضوعات کا انتخاب کیا گیا ہے. اس سے پہلے بھی ہم نے یہاں سے گزارش آپ تک پہنچائی کہ ان میں پہلا موضوع ہے خواتین کا پارلیمنٹ میں مؤثر کردار اور مجموعی طور پر معاشرے میں کردار. دوسرا موضوع اسلام کو مساوات، رواداری اور عدم تفریق کے مذہب کی حیثیت سے اجاگر کرنا. سامعین گرامی، اس کانفرنس میں تیسرے موضوع کا انتخاب کیا گیا ہے کہ مسلم معاشرے میں خواتین کے مسائل اور ان کا حل. اور جناب چوتھا موضوع ہے معاشی ترقی میں خواتین کا مؤثر کردار. سامعین گرامی، خواتین کے حقوق. اچھا، ایک بات کرنا تھی آپ سے کہ سوڈانی وفد کی سربراہ وزیر اعظم کا شکریہ ادا کر رہی ہیں اس وقت، اور اس کی کارروائی براہ راست ہم آپ تک پہنچاتے ہیں.
ان اسلام آباد. سیکنڈلی، وی آر انڈورسنگ دس نومینیشن ان ریکوگنیشن آف ہر ایکسلنسیز انڈیور فار پروموٹنگ مسلم وومن رائٹس، اینڈ ود دی ہوپ that she will also lead our struggle to restructure and restore the true image of our Muslim countries and societies. Thank you.
I presume there is agreement on electing the leader of the Pakistan delegation as the chairperson of the conference. It is so decided.
I thank the delegation of Turkey for the proposal, and I thank the delegation from Sudan for the endorsement, and I thank all the women parliamentarians for this election. And now I declare the inaugural session of the
nominations from the floor for the vice chair.
Sorry. All right. I am told that on the basis of the extensive consultations, it has been agreed that the other members of the Bureau would be the following. The Vice Chairmen, Madam Rasima Chiro, Bosnia-Herzegovina, Madam Hind Al-Husseini, Palestine, Madam Hajit Janet Mukwaya, Uganda, Madam Shaliva Token, Kyrgyzstan. The rapporteur will be Madam Khatija Toure, Chad. And the chairperson of the drafting committee will be Madam Sukinam Domo, Malaysia.
Now I'll request the delegation from Palestine to present what they wanted to the Prime Minister. A delegation from Palestine.
سامعین محترم اس وقت فلسطینی ڈیلیگیشن وزیر اعظم پاکستان محترمہ بے نظیر بھٹو کو اپنی طرف سے تحفے کے طور پر پیش کر رہی ہیں اور یہ تحفہ اب وزیر اعظم پاکستان محترمہ بے نظیر بھٹو جو ایک باکس میں ہے محترم سامعین مندوبین اور حاضرین کو دکھا رہی ہیں اور اب وزیر اعظم پاکستان اپنے نشست پر تشریف لائیں اور تشریف فرما ہو گئیں.
I now declare the inaugural session of the first International Conference of Muslim Women Parliamentarians closed. There's going to be a tea break in the and the general debate will start at 10:45 and I thank my Muslim sisters very much for being with us here. Thank you very much.
سامعین محترم مسلمان ملکوں کی پہلی بین الاقوامی خاتون پارلیمنٹیرین کانفرنس کے افتتاحی اجلاس کی کارروائی آپ تک پہنچی اور اب یہ اجلاس بھی اپنے اختتام کو پہنچ گیا. حاضرین اور مندوبین مہمانان گرامی اور وزیر اعظم پاکستان محترمہ بے نظیر بھٹو سمیت ہال سے باہر جا رہے ہیں اس دروازے سے جو اسٹیج کے ساتھ ہے. اور سامعین محترم وزیر اعظم پاکستان محترمہ بے نظیر بھٹو اس وقت دروازے کے پاس موجود حاضرین اور مندوبین سے ہاتھ ملا رہی تھیں اور اب وہ دروازے سے باہر تشریف لے گئیں اپنے ساتھیوں کے ہمراہ. مسلمان ملکوں کی پہلی بین الاقوامی خاتون پارلیمنٹیرین کانفرنس کے افتتاحی اجلاس کی کارروائی آپ تک پہنچانے کے لیے او بی انجینئرز تھے راشد سلیم صدیقی، عبد المبین خان اور صفدر کنجاہی، پروڈیوسرز نوید احمد چوہان، عبدالحفیظ اور وحید شیخ، نگران تھے محمد شفیع. اپنی معاون بشرا جاوید کے ساتھ اب ہلال احمر آڈیٹوریم سے اپنے میزبان اختر مرزا کو اجازت دیجیے. اب ہم آپ کو اسٹوڈیوز واپس لیے چلتے ہیں.